Talagang nag-init ang sitwasyon. Si Mayor Baste Duterte, wala nang pakundangan, tinawag na brats, sina House Speaker Martin Romualdez at Entrepreneur Elizalde Co. dahil sa mga akusasyon nila laban kay Vice Presidente Sara Duterte. Sinabi pa ni Baste na nakakabuwisit na itinuturo ng mga ito ang ibang tao sa kanilang sariling pagkakamali. Mukhang nagpasiklab ang laban sa politika at tiyak na magiging mainit na usapan ito sa social media. Grabe na nga umano ang kakapalan ng mukha ng dalawang masters ng representatives bukod sa pagiging mga buwaya sa gobyerno, mga mapanisi at mga sinungaling pa. At sa naging isyung ito, ano ang iyong naging reaksyon? Maging malaya sa pagbibigay ng iyong personal na opinion sa comment section. Kung hindi ka pa nakapag-subscribe, aba, subscribe na para lagi kang updated sa mga maiinit na balita at talakayan. Salamat sa panonood at magkita-kita tayo sa susunod na video.
Order which shall recite in details the matters taken up. So what are the matters taken up, Mr. Chair? I think we should be able to comply with these elementary rules as specified in the governing rules.
Well, considering that we are still in the, we have yet to proceed to the interpellation, we are still in the period of recognizing the resource person as well as the witness. With that, the chair declares 1 minute suspension.
tatlo, no?
Hearing resumes. The chair would like to recognize the Honorable Luis Tro Gerville of Batangas 2nd District, Honorable Paul Dasa, Senior Deputy Minority Leader of 1st District, Northern Samar, the Honorable Roel Daniel Manuel of the Kabataan Party List. The chair, the committee would like to take note of the manifestation of the Honorable Marcoleta, but considering that the committee already took cognizance of the preliminary determination, we will proceed to the COA. COA, please. Sino po yung representative ng COA?
Good morning, Mr. Chair. Sa ating mga members of the committee, magandang umaga po. On behalf of the Commission on Audit, we do recognize the plenary power of the Congress in asking questions relating to legislation. And since the invitation only pertains to the budget utilization of the OBP, we can answer questions relating to the to that, Your Honor. That would be all, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. We will now proceed to the next representative, from DBM.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, and good morning to all Your Honors. By the invitation of the Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability, we are here to provide information on the Office of the President's budget in the calendar year CY 2022 to 2024 budget utilization and performance, compliance with the GAA, including fund transfer and budget realignment, as well as the agency's program projects and activities, among others. So any inquiry will just answer during this congressional meeting, Mr. Chair. And we, if ever there's a need for us to provide data and information, we'll do so, Mr. Chair. So good morning.
Thank you. The chair is in receipt of the authority from the Committee on Rules with respect to the motu proprio inquiry on the manifestation of Representative Jinky Luistro during the budget hearing of the Department of Education in the Committee on Appropriation on September 10, 2024. But we will proceed with the preliminary determination later. In the meantime, we will proceed to the interpellation with respect to the privilege speech of Congressman Valeriano. Before we proceed, we will set rules. We will set rules, certain rules or parameters. We will limit the interpellator to 5 minutes. Hindi po kasama yung sagot. And then, pwede po paki-silent po ang inyong mga telepono. Turn off nyo po or silent mode. And please observe proper decorum para hindi po tayo maging magulo at maging maayos lamang po. At lahat po yung mga gustong mag-interpolate, lapit lang po dito sa COMSEC at magpalista. Ang magiging sistema po natin, mauuna po ang minority, and then the majority, minority, majority. Now, we will first recognize representative from the minority, the Honorable Franz Castro.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Nagpapasalamat po ako sa committee na ito po na pinamumunuan po ninyo dahil in-schedule agad natin ano yung naging privilege speech ni Representative Valeriano. Alam niyo po, una po sa lahat, ano, ginigit natin dito na ang tradisyon ay tradisyon. Pero una sa lahat, kung ang tradisyon ay bumabangga sa interes ng mga mamamayan, sa interes ng publiko, at accountability ng mga public officials at saka pagiging transparent ng lahat ng ating mga ginagawa, lalong-lalo na po sa kaperahan o lalong-lalo po sa budget or whatever na pinagkatiwala po ng taong bayan sa atin, ay kailangan po yun yung nauna. Kaya nagpapasalamat po ako na dahil ito po yung magsiset, no, noong mga pwede nating magawa sa rules, mabago sa rules, pwede nating in aid of legislation, lalong-lalo na pinag-uusapan natin ang confidential funds and intelligence funds or confidential funds dito sa Office of the Vice President. At ito ay inaasahan ko na magsiset sa katapusan nitong ano no nitong hearing na ito, yung magsiset talaga na kung dapat o hindi dapat mabigyan ng confidential funds ang ating mga national government agency. At kung meron man, depende kung ano po yung magiging resulta ng inquiry na ito, ay mapahigpit natin, no, yung kung meron man, kung magde-decide later on na may confidential funds pa rin, magde-decide pa rin na magiging mahigpit, no, yung paggamit ng confidential funds. Okay, so dahil hindi naman po nag-oath yung Vice President, Mr. Chair, ang akin na lang mga tanong ay tatanong ko na lang po sa DBM at saka sa COA. Okay, so inaasahan natin, no, na magsasabi kayo ng totoo. So yung first question ko po sa DBM, yung pong, by the way, ay manifest second round kung matatapos ko na yung 5 minutes, Mr. Chair.
Sige po.
Yes. Okay. So, nung 2022 po na budget ng Office of the Vice President sa DBM, Mr. Chair, meron po ba ditong nakalagay na line item for confidential funds?
Please address the chair.
Mr. Chair. Sorry, Mr. Chair.
Yeah. Sa DBM po, please, you are... Yusek Toledo, you are recognized.
Yeah, Mr. Chair, there is no line item for confidential fund, but there is a program that item under that program po na ginagamit po yung confidential fund po.
I'm not satisfied with the answer. Ang tinatanong ko lang po, meron bang line item doon sa budget ng Office of the President na confidential fund? Meron po bang line item po? Yes or no?
There is no, Madam Chair. Yes. But Mr. Chair.
Okay. How about noong 2023? Budget of the Office of the Vice President. Is there a line on about confidential funds?
There is, Madam Mr. Chair, there is a line item for
magkano po, Mr. Chair, yung confidential funds of the Office of the Vice President for 2023?
500 million, Mr. Chair.
Okay, you're correct. Kasi nandito naman, meron naman tayong ano dyan. Okay, so kung i-compare natin, Mr. Chair, yung Office of the Vice President budget GAA 2022 and GAA 2023, so makikita natin agad-agad yung difference, no, na yung confidential fund sa Office of the Vice President noong 2022 ay wala, pero sa Office of the Vice President sa 2023 ay meron. Okay, so paano po nagkaroon ng 125 million na confidential funds ang Office of the Vice President noong 2022, Mr. Chair, sa DBM?
Okay, Mr. Chair. While the OVP has no provision for the confidential funds under the fiscal year 2022 GAA, the said release of funds was charged against the contingent fund using the existing PAP of the Office of the Vice President, which that is the Good Governance Program. Mr. Chair.
Well, ano po yung ibig sabihin ng Good Governance Program po? Kasi defined, alam po natin ano, meron tayong JC o joint circular governing confidential funds. So, can you elaborate on good governance, Mr. Chair, yung binabanggit ninyo po?
The good governance is a program of the OVP, and so that's the basis for us release of the confidential plan of the Office of the Vice President, Mr. Chair.
Well, can you elaborate, ano ba yung good governance? Dahil malinaw po no, doon sa rules or the joint circular governing confidential funds, yung mga pwede lang napondohan ng confidential funds, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, we have already responded to that inquiry. We have already sent the letter dated September 11, 2023, as to what is the all about the good governance program of the OVP, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, this representation has no copy of what you are referring to as the good governance programs. May I request for the copy, Mr. Chair?
Please take note of the manifestation of Congressman Castro Comsec. Would you like to respond, Comsec?
Your Honor, as to the part of the committee secretariat, we have not received a document from the Department of Budget Management. We have sent an invitation on September 13. We are not in receipt of a position paper or any document dated September 11, Your Honor. It might be a different committee.
Okay. But just the same, yes, may I respond to the inquiry as far as what is all about the good governance program, particularly the good governance engagement and social services projects. This is in consideration of the urgency of the safe implementation of various projects and activities of the Office of the Vice President across its satellite offices for the last, the conduct of its official engagement and functional representation in international and local events, the implementation of various projects and activities relevant to national security and peace and order, and implementation of the same with proper security and safety protocols for the benefit of the institution. Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Ma'am, you only have 1 minute.
1 minute.
Please wrap up your...
So did the Office of the Vice President in 2022 ask for a budget for confidential funds for the DBM?
Your Honor, Mr. Chair, for 2022, there is no request for the... confidential in the budget, but we have, as mentioned, they have requests for the chargeable. We have requests for 2022, but that was charged to the contingent fund.
There was a so may request po ba o wala?
Doon sa proposed budget for 2022, wala po.
Pero saan po kinuha yung 125? Sinasabi nyo kanina, Mr. Chair, ay doon sa contingent fund. So hindi po ba kapag merong request for a lump sum o merong ibibigay or pagkukuhanan yung lump sum, dapat may request?
Okay. Yes, Mr. Chair. So during the implementation of the fiscal year 2022 budget, there was a request coming from the Office of the Vice President to release an additional requirement for the fiscal year 2022 budget. Basically, hindi lang po yung confidential plan, but also for some PS and MOE requirements. Now, this was...
Pinag-usapan lang natin yung confidential funds.
So, Mr. Chair, yes, there was a request coming from the Office of the Vice President during the implementation of the budget in that year. So, that's why in...
Mr. Chair, may cut you on that with due respect. So, may ask Mr. Chair the request...
Last yes. question, please.
So, second down na lang ako, Mr. Chair. May ask the DBM, Mr. Chair, the letter request from the Office of the Vice President. So, yun na lang, Mr. Chair, at itutuloy ko na lang po mamaya.
The DBM is requested to submit the letter of the Honorable Vice President.
Yes, Mr.
letter
Chair.
Of the Honorable. Please submit it to the COMSEC.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Next to interpolate is Honorable Nika Swansing. You have 5 minutes.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, I was just hoping to take this opportunity because COA, the right team from COA is already here. So if I may request the COMSEC, Mr. Chair, and the permission of the Honorable Chairman to pull up some slides on the screen.
Mr. Yes, Chair. Please.
Mr. Chair, these were the same slides that I presented to the Committee on Appropriations during the deliberation on the budget of the Office of the Vice President 2 weeks ago. For those who were not there in the meeting, a very quick summary, Mr. Chair, in the interest of time. So these the slides were put together based on the different documents submitted by COA in compliance to the subpoenaed Duces Tecum and accomplishment report submitted by the Office of the Vice President. And here, Mr. Chair, several things to note. Essentially, we have summarized across the four quarters in terms of the disbursement of the confidential expenses of the Office of the Vice President, the different audit findings of the Commission on Audit across the four different quarters. So for Q4 2022, which is the subject of the notice of disallowance, it was found that there's a 73 million out of 125 million that was considered by COA as disallowed in audit. And then for the succeeding quarters, accordingly, Mr. Chair, you would see here the proportion of the 125 million, which was questioned in the audit order memorandum and not questioned across the succeeding quarters. During the deliberations of the Office of the Vice President, President's budget, I directed a question towards COA to please enlighten us as to the grounds for the notice of disallowance for Q4 2022 and the three succeeding quarters which were subjected to the AOM, Mr. Chair. However, during the OVP budget hearing, the representative of COA, Assistant Commissioner Alexander Juliano, said that he was not privy to the information as he was not part of the team handling the confidential expenses. So, Mr. Chair, I believe the team who did the audit is present in today's hearing. So if we may request, Mr. Chair, COA to please enlighten us for the four different quarters covered by the notice of the disallowance and the audit order memorandum. May we please request, Mr. Chair, COA to please enlighten us as to the ground. So perhaps, Mr. Chair, we can go quarter by quarter. We can first start with Q4 2022, which was the subject of the notice of disallowance.
Any representative from COA?
Mr. Chair, Attorney Gloria Camora, State Auditor of
Attorney
the Ikaw,
Camora.
Yes, will answer the question.
Attorney Camora, you're recognized.
Congresswoman.
Yes, good morning, Madam, Mr. Chair. As to the 2022 notice of disallowance,
Ma'am, pakilakasan po ninyo yung boses nyo, hindi marinig.
Okay. There were three items that are part of the notice of disallowance. The first one is on the non-submission of documents on the payment of rewards. The second one is charging some items that are not compliant under the rules joint circular. And the third one is non-submission of the revised accomplishment report of the office of the VP to the three regulatory offices, which are the Office of the President, the Senate President, and the Speaker of the House of Representatives, because what they have submitted was the original one, and they made an amendment, but as of now, they have not resubmitted the amended accomplishment report.
Mr. Chair, if COA may please enlighten to explain to us, because it seems a little bit technical po as to how it was explained by COA. Kung pwede po maipaliwanag po sa atin in non-technical terms as to the grounds for the disallowance po.
COA, pakisimplify po. Please explain it in layman's term.
Yes po. Basically, the disallowances is because hindi po sila nag-submit ng required na documents under the joint circular.
Mr. Chair, if we may move to the next slide.
Please proceed.
Comsec, next slide, please. Here, Mr. Chair, shows a breakdown of the different expense items listed in the accomplishment report for Q4 2022 and the three succeeding quarters, which were the subject of the AOMs. Mr. Chair, I would like to again throw the question to COA, because it seems to me, I am not an auditor, so it seems to me that across the three succeeding quarters, the categories that were flagged as questioned in the AOM are similar across the three succeeding quarters. So, pare-pareho po yung naka-orange po, payment of reward, yung provision of medical and food aid, at saka po payment of incentives or traveling relative to the confidential operation. So, Mr. Sheriff, I may request COA to please enlighten us as to the reason why these categories seem to be repeatedly flagged across the succeeding quarters under audit.
COA?
Yes, Mr. Chair. As to the payment of rewards, the joint circular requires a document, the supporting documents evidencing the success of the information gathering. As far as the documents that they have submitted, we are not, so far, we are not satisfied with the documents they have submitted. So we ask them to submit the documents that would satisfy the joint circular. As to the provision of food and medical items, again, we ask them for... for an explanation, since by themselves, food and medical aid appears to not fall under the expenses allowed by the joint circular. So we are asking for explanation on those items. And then it's the same with traveling expenses, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, in the interest of time, I'll move to my final slide.
You still have 1 minute.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chair. Clarificatory question sa Mr. Chair, kasi at least nandito na ba yung team sa COA. Last slide, please, Comsec. Here, Mr. Chair, I would like to ask COA, because... very interestingly po, isa po sa mga napansin natin is the length of disbursement for the 125 million across the different quarters po. Meron po ba na information yung COA as to how yung ano po, yung how the disbursements were done in terms of the speed by which the disbursements were done. Like, for example, po, the 125 million in December were spent in 11 days as opposed to in Q3 2023 po, wherein it was spent in 79 days. So, kasi po, one thing that we can see as well in the previous slide is regardless of the length of the disbursement or the speed of the disbursement or the areas of surveyed, of surveillance, if you can move to the previous slide, ComSec. Ito po. The numbers of areas under surveillance are different and the speed of the disbursement is different as well. But it seems like the expenditure patterns are very similar po across categories and across the different quarters. So, meron po bang nakita yung COA with regards to that po, Mr. Chair?
Please wrap up your questions. Pakisagot na lang po. Tapos na po kayo.
Mr. Chair, since we were given the data on the areas and they have also submitted the evidences of payments, we did not conduct a study on the speed by which the frequency of the payments. As long as we were satisfied with the number of areas that they have served. So, if you can average it based on that, the number of areas, I think it is possible to be spending that the said amounts.
Mr. Chair, final question na lang
okay,
po.
Okay, last question.
Because the AOMs were issued po in February 1, 2024 for the first AOM and then the second AOM po on August 8, 2024. Reading through the AOMs po, the Office of the Vice President is given 15 days to respond to the AOMs. I believe the first one has been responded to in April. So, meron na po bang response doon po sa August 8 na AOM?
Yes, Madam Chair, they have submitted their reply to the AOMs and the audit is on the compliance is ongoing.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Those are my clarificatory questions po. Clarification because the team handling the audit is now here. Just wanted to clarify po dun po sa slides na pre-present po nung nakalaang OVP budget hearing. Maraming salamat po, Mr. Chair.
May I approach the table? Request 1 minute suspension.
The chair declares 1 minute suspension. Session resumes.
Mr. Chair, may I request...
The Honorable Vice President is recognized.
Thank you. May I request to leave the inquiry?
Ma'am, pwede naman po, considering na hindi naman din po kayo naka-out and alam naman po namin marami rin po kayong ginagawa, the Vice President is excused.
Thank you.
Thank you po,
ma'am. Thank you, everyone. Good morning.
1 minute suspensions declared by the chair.
iba pang mga nagtitake ng major function sa OVP. So, Mr. Chair, we have...
...did not take the oath, no? And I think wala naman siyang sasabihin kung tatanungin natin. So, buti na lang na umalis na siya. Well, next meeting, Mr. Chair, pwede ba nating imbitahin from the office of the Vice...
No, from the, just so that we know how to decide on the motion, if we will agree with it or to object. Mr. Chair, my understanding, I understand there were two names mentioned, but yung isa po, si Ms. Gina Acosta, may we know from the COMSEC if she was already invited?
COMSEC?
Yes, thank you, Your Honor. No, she was not invited. We were not informed that she was a special disbursing officer, Your Honor. So she is also not in the website, Your Honor. Of the
so those two names were not invited yet?
Yes, Your Honor, not okay. Invited. Ms. Gina F. Acosta, the special disbursing officer, and Ms. Julieta Villa del Rey, the chief accountant of the Office of the Vice President.
Thank you then, Mr. Chair. In that case, I will join the motion of the Honorable Castro. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Is there any second to the motion?
Second, Chairman. Chairman.
Is there any objection?
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Congressman Paduano.
Before the chairman rules with regards to the motion being made by the Honorable Franz Castro, let me ask the chairman. Since we invited to the motion of the Honorable Castro, a certain Ms. Acosta and Villa del Rey, Julieta, Mr. Chairman, can we ask if, kasi po, if we invite those resource persons or witnesses, no, resource persons or witnesses, they should be, we should have a basis for them to be invited. Now, as far as I know, during the appropriations budget deliberation with regards to the budget of the Office of the Vice President, the name of the two officials from the OBP was mentioned. But I hope, Mr. Chairman, there's a record with regards to what really transpired during the budget deliberation of the appropriations. And with that, Mr. Chairman, let me also ask, no, for the Committee on Appropriations to submit in this committee just purposes of record and to justify the motion being made by the Honorable Franz Castro for them to submit, no, through the Appropriations Committee, through the chair, Chairman Saldico, the excerpts and the documents submitted to the committee with regards to the justification for the presence of the two officials of the OBP in the next hearing, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Noted. We will inform the COMSEC to please take note of the manifestation of the Honorable Paduano. In the meantime, we will rule on the motion of the Honorable Franz Castro. Is there any objection? Hearing none, the motion is carried.
May I proceed, Mr. Chair?
The Honorable Raul Manuel, hindi po minus yung inyong oras. You still have...
Sige,
you still have 4 minutes.
Okay, thank
Please
you.
Please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, nabanggit po kanina na hindi qualified sa paggamit ng confidential funds ng Office of the Vice President for 2022 ang medical and food aid. Can we confirm this from the Commission on Audit?
As of yung AOM po namin, since medical...
COA, please wait to be recognized by the chair. Attorney Camora, you are recognized. And please address your answer to the chair.
Mr. Chair, since as of the review of the documents, we have deemed them not qualified as confidential expenses since they just indicated food and medical supplies as is.
Mr. Chair, how much po yung amount na dineclare ng OVP na pinagamitan di umano ng medical and food aid?
Mr. Chair, anong period po?
For 2022, yung confidential funds.
For 2022, it was 35 million for supplies.
For medical and food aid.
For medical and supplies, Mr. Chair, 40 million pesos.
Sa pagtingin natin, Mr. Chair, bagamat syempre gusto natin na makatulong ang ating mga ahensya ng gobyerno, mapagbuti yung pag-provide ng mga services, pero tingin natin, Mr. Chair, ay questionable nga kung kukunin sa confidential funds ang pag-provide ng medical and food aid. Lalo na't supposedly nga transparent, magkano talaga yung nagagastos para dyan, tapos sa bawat beneficiary din, magkano yung worth ng kanilang nakukuha, ilan din yung beneficiaries. E di ibig sabihin, Mr. Chair, delikado kapag yung ganitong mga tipo ng serbisyo ay ang magiging source natin ano ay confidential funds. Sa experience po ba, Mr. Chair, ng Commission on Audit, meron din ba dating mga agencies ng pamahalaan na nag-declare na gumamit sila ng confidential funds para sa medical and food aid?
Kuwa, please answer.
Mr. Chair, we have not come across, or kung meron man, Mr. Chair, it has not been under my audit po.
So,
may iba po kasing auditors.
May ibang? Pakilakasan po yung inyong boses.
May ibang auditors po. So, hindi lang po kami. Opo. So, I am not aware if may mga ibang agencies po na nagde-declare ng medical and food supplies.
Okay. So, Mr. Chair, ibig sabihin hindi standard practice na ang pantulong sa ating mga kababayan ay kinukuha siya mula sa confidential funds. Tama po ba, Mr. Chair?
Koa, please answer.
Tama po, Mr. Chair, pero I would like to point out po sa joint circular that supplies, materials are actually allowed except that you have to identify them as used in confidential activities like surveillance activities. Yan lang po, Mr. Chair.
So, ibig sabihin, Mr. Chair, under our current rules, meron siyang qualifier pero hindi absolute na ibig sabihin kung based lang sa personal na kagustuhan ng opisyal ay gagamitin niya yung confidential funds para sa medical and food aid. Tama po ba, Mr. Chair?
Yes, Mr. Chair. As long as the purchase or rental of supplies, materials, and equipment or for confidential operations, they will comply with the joint circular po.
Okay. Mr. Chair, kasunod naman, na-mention din kanina na walang bagong submission ang Office of the Vice President regarding nga doon sa notice of disallowance. Can the Commission on Audit expound on that, Mr. Chair? Kasi nga, ang dating kasi sa ilan sa mga kababayan natin ay as if ba hindi nabibigyan ng pagkakataon ang OVP para talaga ipaliwanag, tapos after the notice of disallowance na actually ang nais nun, Mr. Chair, ay pinapabalik sa OVP yung hindi maipaliwanag na paggastos ng confidential fund. So para lang po talaga malinaw, Mr. Chair, nabigyan ng pagkakataon ng OVP to explain. And meron po bang mga latest na submissions ang OVP on top of those na naipasa niya na dati?
Mr. Chair, if it pertains to the 2022 confidential fund,
yes, Mr. Chair.
Wala pa pong, actually, hindi na po sila required mag-reply sa amin since it's already a notice of disallowance. The remedy na po is either settlement or appeal the notice of disallowance po.
Okay. So, Mr. Chair, ibig sabihin, para po maunawaan na ating mga kababayan, may pinapabalik na confidential funds na ginamit ng Office of the Vice President noong 2022. Ang options ay ibalik yon or umapela. And kung strong naman po yung appeal at ibig sabihin ay kakayaning ma-justify, edi pwedeng hindi pabalikin. Tama po ba, Mr. Chair?
Tama po, depende po sa decision ng commission proper, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So kung doon sa second option, Mr. Chair, na umapela, meron bang mga pinasa na mga dokumento ang Office of the Vice President para po formally sila na makapag-appeal para hindi sila require na ibalik yung confidential funds na na-flag? Meron po bang naipasa, Mr. Chair?
Wala po kaming information, Mr. Chair, kung nakapag-file po sila ng appeal nila. It's with the commission proper na po, so hindi na po sa ICFA yun fina-file.
So, Mr. Chair, do we have a representative from the Commission on Audit mismo? Labas pa dun sa ICFA. Meron po ba dito, Mr. Chair? So we can get the response from them, Mr. Chair.
We have here the representative from government audit sector, Mr. Fahad bin Tomawis. Could you respond to the query of the Honorable Manuel?
Good morning, Mr. Chair. Please be informed that I'm not in the position to answer the question because I'm the audit team leader of the regular audit of the OBP. For the confidential fund, it is part of the ICFAO, and for the appeal, it is part of the commission proper of the Commission on Audit. So it must be addressed to the commission proper of the Commission on Audit.
Mr. Chair, meron po ba taga-commission?
May I ask the COMSEC if she invited the representative of COA?
Mr. Chair, there's an office that monitors the filing of an appeal, which is the Commission Secretariat Office. So on the question on whether there's an appeal that has been filed by the OVP, we will validate on that.
Mr. Chair,
please do so.
Yes,
since kailangan din nating malaman no, dito sa committee, how long po yung duration para ma-verify po at ma-check yung ganong impormasyon?
Attorney.
Mr. Chair, the Lapitan. OPP has 180 days to file an appeal. So we will wait for that within that period, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so Mr. Chair, kailan po nag-start ang pagbibilang ng 180 days or nearly 6 months?
Sino pong
Mr.
sasagot?
Mr. Chair,
Attorney Camora, you're recognized.
Sorry. Mr. Chair, it runs from the receipt of the OVP of the ND, which is per our record, it was on August 9, 2024.
Okay, so ibig sabihin, Mr. Chair, aabangan natin ang magiging action. Nonetheless, Mr. Chair,
please wrap up your question.
Yes, Mr. Chair, thank you. Para lang maliwanag talaga at hindi po nadidisinform ang ating mga kababayan, ibig sabihin po, ang merong dapat na proactive na ginagawa para maghabol at ipaliwanag kung paano ginamit yung confidential funds ay ang OVP po talaga. Hindi po pwedeng linlangin yung ating mga kababayan na it is the burden of other offices, other officials na mag-present po ng mga ebidensya. Kasi in fact, ang sabi na nga po ng COA, kung hindi mag-aapela, dapat po talaga ibalik ang hindi maipaliwanag na paggastos ng confidential funds. Yun lang po, Mr. Chair. Maraming salamat.
Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, before I recognize the next interpellator, the Honorable Paduano, you're
Thank
recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Germane to the question asked by Congressman Manuel. To the COA, now, the Office of the Vice President made an appeal. Okay? Now, ang question, timeline po tayo. Timeline. So, an appeal will be discussed dun sa director, then commission proper. How long will it take? Yung
Goa.
Appeal.
Sino
how long
inyo?
Will it take?
Goa. Attorney Camora.
Mr. Chair, may I ask
The appeal.
The appeal is...
How long will it take?
They are given 180 days po. From
tama, 180 days.
Yes, Mr.
So,
Chair.
So, within 6 months.
Yes, Mr.
And
Chair.
And after that, after the 180 days, which is 6 months...
Ang tanong po ni Congressman Paduano, after the appeal, gaano po ninyo katagal bago sagutin or maglabas po kayo ng recommendation?
Hindi po. Chairman, kasi the appeal, the any office, no, for that matter, and in this case, the Office of the Vice President is given 180 days or 6 months from the appeal. Now, so, bibigyan sila ng 6 months. And now, for example, the appeal supposedly started when the NDA, no, Notice of Disallowance started January. So, ang appeal niya, no, appeal niya will be pwedeng June 30. Tama? On that year. Tama? Last day, for example, of that 180 days. Tama?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Then again, after the appeal, iakyat sa commission paper.
Mr. Chair, the appeal is filed before the commission proper, Mr. Chair.
So, hindi na dadaan doon sa director. Diretso na po sa commission proper.
Hindi na po.
Okay, now, upon the receipt of the commission proper, how long will it take for the appeal, for the commission proper to decide?
Under our rules, Mr. Chair, 60 days po. But,
hey, sorry, 60 days.
Yes.
That's 2 months. Okay. But what, please?
But the commission proper may release its decision beyond the 60 days, considering the peculiarity of the case and, of course, the appreciation of the submitted documents, Your Honor.
So, you're telling the peculiarity of the case in the case of the Office of the Vice President is so peculiar? That is why that will go beyond the 60 days? Are you saying that?
Your Honor, actually, what the rules prescribe is 60 days.
Yun ang rules, yes. Di ba? Now, Mr. Chairman, just a short manifestation. Ito ngayon, problema. Kasi we are conducting this inquiry in aid of legislation because we have to have a legislative action in this case. Again, part of my manifestation, Mr. Chair, we have to review that 180 days. Because that is too long. Kasi, pwede kasi mangyari talaga na last day of that 180 days, sa kanila, sagutin yung appeal. Diba, magpadala ng appeal. Then after that, under the rules, is another 60 days. And it will take 8 months, Mrs. Chairman.
At sa naging isyong ito, ano ang iyong naging reaksyon? Maging malaya sa pagbibigay ng iyong personal na opinion sa comment section. Kung hindi ka pa nakapag-subscribe, aba, subscribe na para lagi kang updated sa mga maiinit na balita at talakayan. Salamat sa panonood at magkita-kita tayo sa susunod na video. We'll be right back.